Lately I've been hard to reach. I've been too long on my own. Everybody has a private world where they can be alone. Are you calling me? Are you trying to get through? Are you reaching out for me? I'm reaching out for you.
I'm just so fucking depressed, I just can't seem to get out this slump. If I could just get over this hump, but I need something to pull me out this dump. I took my bruises, took my lumps, fell down and I got right back up. But I need that spark to get psyched back up in order for me to pick the mic back up. I don't know how or why or when I ended up in this position I'm in. I'm starting to feel distant again, so I decided just to pick this pen up and try to make an attempt to vent, but I just can't admit or come to grips with the fact that I may be done with rap. I need a new outlet, and I know some shit's so hard to swallow, but I just can't sit back and wallow in my own sorrow. But I know one fact, I'll be one tough fact to follow. One tough fact to follow, I'll be one tough fact to follow. Here today, gone tomorrow, but you'd have to walk 1,000 miles in my shoes just to see what it's like to be me. I'll be you, let's trade shoes just to see what it'd be like to feel your pain, feel mine, go inside each other's minds just to see what we find. Look at shit through each other's eyes, but don't let them say you ain't beautiful. Oh, oh, they can all get fucked, just stay true.
I can't believe you killed him! How am I gonna look after my baby now?
You what? Marty was an asshole! He treated you worse than shit!
I'm sorry! I just... Hey, look! Marty's kin are gonna be coming for you now. We better get you someplace safe.
I can handle Marty's kin, Louise.
I just wanna make sure you're safe, that's all.
Look! You and Mary Beth are gonna be better off without Marty, you know?
Are we? It's just everything's changing so fast.
Everything's gonna be fine.
You're okay, Vic Vance.
You are a mess.
And you're wonderful. A wonderful drug dealing thieving murderer.
Come on, guys.
I was doing it for us.
Who are you trying to kid? You don't give a shit about me.
Not now, I don't.
You know what? You make me want to puke, you self-righteous dick.
Ah, get lost.
Okay. Vic, I knew you'd come. I think I need a doctor.
Nobody asked for life to deal us with these bullshit hands with doubt. We gotta take these cards ourselves and flip them. Don't expect no help. Now I could have either just
sat on
my ass and pissed and moaned, or take the situation
look,
and put your
post in my hip and keep my arms. I shouldn't have said what I did.
I was never the type of kid to wait by the door and pack his bags. I sat on the porch and hoped and prayed for a dad to show up who never did. I just wanted to fit in every single place, every school I went. I dreamed of being that cool kid, even if it meant acting stupid. And Edna always told me, keep making that face and it gets stuck like that. Meanwhile, I'm just standing there holding my tongue, trying to talk like that. Till I suck my tongue on that frozen stop sign, pulled at 8 years old. I learned my lesson then, cause I wasn't trying to impress my friends no more. But I already told you my whole life story, not just based on my description. Cause where you see it from where you're sitting, it's probably 110% different. I guess we would have to walk a mile in each other's shoes at least. What size you wear? I wear 10s. Let's see if you can fit your feet
in my shoes just to see what it's like to be me. I'll be you, let's trade shoes just to see what it'd be like to feel your pain, feel mine. Go inside each other's minds just to see what we find. Look at shit through each other's eyes, but don't let them say you ain't beautiful. Oh, they can all get fucked, just stay true.
Everybody has a private part.
And to the rest of the world, God gave you them shoes to fit you. So put them on and wear them. Be yourself, man. Be proud of who you are. Even if it sounds corny, you never let no one tell you. You ain't beautiful. You ain't beautiful.